Hello, welcome to our channel, and in this lecture we are going to discuss about presence of starch and presence of starch in leaves and factors are the materials essential for the process of the photosynthesis, and next air and photosynthesis. And in the lecture 1 we have discussed about the autotrophic nutrition and photosynthesis. If you have not watched the lecture 1, please go back and watch that lecture and come back to the lecture 2 so that you can understand it clearly. Okay, first we'll discuss about the activity 1. So the activity 1, it is going to discuss about the presence of starch in the leaves. In the previous lesson we have discussed about what is glucose and what is starch. Okay, so the starch and glucose, they are sugars. The glucose is a simple sugar and the starch is a complex sugar. Okay, the complex sugar. So this is only the difference between the glucose and starch. So in this topic, in the activity 1, we are going to see how the starch is produced. Okay, what does the indication of starch? So it is completely based upon the photosynthesis. Okay, we are going to see whether starch is produced in the photosynthesis or not. Okay, so let us see about the lecture. Okay, first we have to arrange the apparatus as shown in the figure. So first of all, we have to take one plant leaf. Okay, let us consider this is the plant. Okay, so the plant contains leaves. Okay, first take out one leaf. Okay, we have to bring the leaf to the laboratory, and first of all we have to take one beaker. Okay, so we have to take one beaker. This is the beaker which is used for the boiling of the water, and the beaker has to be kept on the Bunsen burner. Okay, so this is the Bunsen burner, and this is a tripod stand. So this is a tripod stand, this is a Bunsen burner. We have to take one beaker, keep it on the tripod stand, and we have to boil it. Okay, we have to boil the water which is present in the beaker. So the water should be filled around 70%. Okay, and when the water is boiling, we have to place one leaf, the which is taken from the plant, into the boiling water. When the leaf is boiled, what you have to see? So we have to boil the leaf up to some extent, and we have to take out the leaf, and we have to dip in the methylated spirit, the boiling test tube which is containing the methylated spirit. So the methylated spirit which is present in the boiling tube also should be little bit warmer. Okay, the leaf is placed in the methylated spirit. Okay, the question is why we have to keep the boil, where we have to place the boiled leaf in the methylated spirit? The answer is to remove the chlorophyll. The leaf is green in color. Okay, so we have to remove the green color. So if you place the methylated spirit, what will happen? The green color will lose. Okay, the green color will be lost. Okay, so this is only the reason. To remove the green color, we are going to place the boiled leaf in the methylated spirit. So what is known as methylated spirit? So methyl groups are present in the spirit. Spirit is nothing but it is a alcohol. Okay, methyl group containing alcohol is known as methylated spirit. Okay, so after boiling in the methylated spirit, remove the leaf. So when you remove the leaf from the methylated spirit, the leaf looks in this way. Okay, the pale yellow white color. Okay, this is the indication that the green color from the leaf has lost and the chlorophyll is dissolved. Okay, the chlorophyll is dissolved into the methylated spirit. So as a result, the leaf turns into pale yellow white color. Okay, so the pale white yellow color leaf, what we are going to do, we are going to add some amount of iodine solution, and when we don't have the iodine solution, we have to use a betadiene solution also. So iodine, okay, or betadiene, okay, betadiene solution, so can be used to identify the starch. So if you pour few drops of iodine solution or betadiene solution, what will happen? So this color of the leaf, okay, the pale yellow white color of the leaf will turn into blue black color. So this is the color that is going to reach. So what is the reason for it? The reason is the starch. Okay, the starch is present in the leaf. How the starch is present in the leaf? Why? Because of the photosynthesis. The photosynthesis produces the glucose molecules. Okay, the glucose molecules turns into the starch. Okay, the starch is nothing but joined or the monomeric units of the glucose molecule. So the starch is going to react with iodine or betadiene solution. As a result, it will turn into the blue black color. Okay, the starch will react only with the iodine solution or betadine solution. If you mix the glucose plus iodine, will you see the color? Will you see the blue black color? No, there is no blue black color if you mix, where if you react the glucose with iodine. So iodine is going to react with only starch. Okay, so by this way, if you see the leaf which is turning into blue black color, that is an indication for the photosynthesis has been occurred in the leaves, and hence the chemical and the sunlight light energy is converted into chemical energy. What is that chemical energy? The glucose molecules are starch. So the starch is the chemical energy. So not only starch but also the glucose is a chemical energy. Okay, so this is the main important thing. So the next is, and above an experiment we can indicate that solar energy means light, sunlight. The sunlight is transferred or converted into chemical energy. Okay, so this is about the experiment or activity. Now there is another small introduction or process that is known as factors or the materials essential for the process of the photosynthesis. So it means they are explaining about what are the materials that are essential for the process. So they are carbon dioxide, water and chlorophyll, light, and these all are the important materials. Light, chlorophyll, water and carbon dioxide, these all are the main important materials essential for the photosynthesis. Okay, so if anyone is missing, there is no process of the photosynthesis. And to know this, to know such kind of information, the scientist took around 300 years. Such kind of long amount of time is necessary. Why? Because in those days, in those olden days, there were no scientific experiments or scientific tools, advanced tools are not present in those days. So this is only the reason the scientist took such kind of time, okay, to find about them. So this is about factors or materials essential for the photosynthesis. Remember, carbon dioxide, water, chlorophyll and light, these are the main materials essential for the photosynthesis. Okay, so with these materials the photosynthesis will occur and leading to the production of the glucose plus water plus oxygen. Okay, so this is the main important thing. So next, the water and photosynthesis. Here they are explaining about what is the relation between the water and photosynthesis. So according to the von Helmont, we have discussed about this von Helmont in the classes, in the primary classes like 7th. In the 7th also we have discussed about von Helmont. Okay, so what he said that water is essential to increase the plant mass. First of all, we have to understand about what is meant by mass. Mass means weight. Okay, the weight is also known as a mass. So to increase the plant weight, what is essential? The water is essential. So here he said about it. But today we know that not only water but also other important process essential. What is that important process? That important process is photosynthesis. So the plants contains water, it is obvious thing. Okay, correct. So but also only the water? No, not only the water but also the glucose, okay, plus proteins plus vitamins. These all are the main important components which is present in the plant. So these all components are going to help the plant to increase its weight. Okay, so this is about the water and photosynthesis relation. Not only water but also other components are essential for the increasing of the plant weight or plant mass. We can call it as a plant body mass. Okay, so next is the air and photosynthesis. So here we are going to discuss about what is the importance or relation between the air and photosynthesis. So we have to discuss about one scientist that is known as Joseph Priestley. So he belongs to the year 1733 to 1804, and in the year 1770 he did one experiment to know the essential or important role of the air in the photosynthesis. Okay, so this scientist, the Joseph Priestley, discovered the oxygen in the year 1771. The experiment started in the year 1770, but the oxygen was discovered by him in the 1771. But he did not give any name to that gas. But the name was given by the Lavoisier. So the Lavoisier in the year 1775, he gave the name the oxygen to that particular gas which is released by the plants. Okay, so what he did? He did one experiment. So first of all, he arranged the experiment. That experiment name is known as Priestley's experiment, Joseph Priestley's experiment. So he took one surface, flat surface. He kept one bell jar. Okay, what is meant by bell jar? Bell jar is nothing but transparent. It is made up of transparent glass. Okay, it looks like almost a bell. Okay, that you see in temples and churches and so on. So it looks like a bell. And in the bell jar, what he did? He kept one candle. Before placing the bell jar on the surface, he kept one candle, the burning candle. Okay, so he closed the bell jar. So what happens after some time? The candle will turn off. So he noticed that the candle is going to damage the air. Some amount of gas is released into the air and some amount of gas is consumed by the air, and hence the air is damaged, that is leading to the turning of the candle. Okay, in the next step he introduced one mouse also. Okay, he introduced the live mouse and also candle. So after some time the mouse suffocated and also candle turned off. So this is the main reason. So the, as a result you can see the mouse died and candle turned off. So this is the main thing that you can notice. And in the third, so introduce one mint plant and also the candle and the mouse. As a result, what you can see, this mint plant is going to absorb the carbon dioxide which is released from the candle and also released from the mouse, and hence by absorbing carbon dioxide and sun and also light, it is going to perform photosynthesis. We know that during the end product of the photosynthesis, the oxygen is released. So the oxygen is released from the bell jar, leading to the living condition of the mouse and burning condition of the candle. Okay, this is the main important thing. So there is one question that in the textbook, there is one question that how the priestly ignited, or how you can ignite the candle from the outside. So that it is simple. So this is a bell jar, okay, and there is a plant, mint plant is there, candle is there. So you have to ignite the candle. So previously there was completely carbon dioxide, you have kept the mint plant for few days. Okay, and we have to see whether the oxygen is released into the bell jar or not. So how you can ignite the candle without lifting the bell jar? So the answer is simple. You have to place the lens. What is that lens? Convex lens. So convex lens, or you can use the magnifying lens. So and focus the sunlight. Okay, the focus the sunlight onto the wick of the candle. So this is the sun. The sunlight is falling on it, on the magnifying glass, and focus all the rays onto the wick of the candle. What happens? The wick will get ignited due to this sunlight. So due to the point. So this is one of the idea so that you can use to ignite the candle from the outside without lifting the bell jar. Okay. So the next thing is, nowadays in the modern days we have the igniters. Okay. So electric igniters. So already the bell jar is fitted with the electric igniters. So what will happen? So it contains some electrodes, the positive and negative electrode. So what will happen if you pass the current? There is a generation of some kind of spark. With the help of this spark, the candle can be ignited. So these are the two reasons. So the priestly experiment, what it confirmed? It confirmed that a gaseous exchange was going on, and the plant were giving out the gas that support the burning candle, burning condition of the candle, and survival of the animal. Okay. So these gas, oxygen gas, is essential for those two processes, that is burning of the candle and living condition of the animal. Okay. So how do the plant taking air and utilize the carbon dioxide for the photosynthesis and oxygen for the respiration? So what they are asking, how the plant is going to take the carbon dioxide? So see here. So this is the leaf. Okay. This is a leaf, and beneath the underside of the leaf, you can see the tiny, tiny pores. So these tiny, tiny pores are known as stomata. These stomata are going to absorb the carbon dioxide from the environment. Carbon dioxide will be absorbed into the leaf through these stomata. Okay. As a result, the carbon dioxide is available, light is also available, the water is present in the leaf. Now it is performing the photosynthesis. Okay. So this is about it. And also it is the case in case of a leaf. So what about the stem? So let us consider this is the plant stem. Okay. So this is the plant stem. So the plant stem contains some kind of tiny, tiny holes. Okay, microscopic tiny, tiny holes you can see on the surface. Honestly, you can see there is some little bit elevated surfaces on the plant stem. These are known as lenticels. These lenticels are going to absorb the gases like oxygen, so or carbon dioxide. So as a result, the air can be taken through the lenticels and also leaf. So which gas they are going to take? The leaves are going to take both carbon dioxide and also oxygen, and lenticels are going to take oxygen. Okay, And when they are going to take the carbon dioxide during the night time, when there is sunlight, the leaves are going to take the carbon dioxide. When there is no sunlight in the night time, the leaves are going to take the oxygen. Okay, night time. Night time, the oxygen leaves are going to take the oxygen. Why? Because in the night time there is no sunlight, there is no energy, so they have to take the oxygen for the energy. That process is known as cellular respiration. Okay. So not only that, the plants carry out the gases exchange through the loose tissue. The loose tissue is present in the stem, that you can see the lenticels. Okay, and also roots. And if you see the roots also, if you see, this is a root, and the root contains small pores. These pores are going to take the air which is present in the soil. The soil contains the air plus water. Okay, the air plus water. So the water will be taken, the air also will be taken through the roots. Okay, so this is the main important thing. So the plant can take all air from the stem, that is known as lenticels, from the root hairs, and from the leaves. Okay, so the choice of gas is required at the level of the organelles. So level of the organelles involved in the process of the photosynthesis and respiration. In the leaves, the gas is taken, carbon dioxide for the photosynthesis, oxygen for the respiration, and the stem also the oxygen for the respiration, and roots. Okay, so this is about the respiration and the gases required. Okay, and I hope this lecture is helpful to you. And if you haven't subscribed to our channel, so that you will get notification about the class and the class's starting time. And like the video, share, and also comment. Okay, if you share the video, your friends also going to get benefited. And comment, if you comment in the comment section, we will know about the water, your requirements, and also you can clear your doubts in the comment section below, and so on. And in the next lecture, we are going to discuss about carbon dioxide necessary for the photosynthesis, light and photosynthesis, that is in the lecture 3. Okay, we are going to discuss about this lecture 3 in the next lecture. Okay, and we will see you in the next lesson.